She was known as a nymph with the goat, or in other words, she was just a goat, but for this case, we'll use the nymph with the goat. She had a horn called the cornucopia. It said that Hercules broke it off the river god, and it was always filled with fruits. Dianad was a beautiful girl who was abducted by an evil satyr. The satyr takes her, but he has another thing coming to him whenever Poseidon came and take her back.
Antiope has two sons named Zeus, Zethus, and Amphion. She abandons them in the mountains out of fear because of their father. But while they were gone, men came and were mean to her, so they came back to avenge her. Minerva was a fine weaver and considered her things to be so, but Arachne challenged Minerva. They tied, but Minerva proceeded to beat her. Out of shame, Arachne hung herself, but was brought back to life into a spider by Minerva. Aristaeus was a beekeeper who loved his bees and would do anything for them, but one day the bees die. He goes to his mother and asks her what he should do. She says to go to Proteus and he can get the bees back. So he goes to Proteus and challenges him to a fight. Aristaeus wins and Proteus grants him his bees back.
When Tithonus was born, his mother prayed to Zeus to give him immortality. He granted her her wish. He blesses Tithonus with immortality. There was one problem, though. He aged eternally and would not stop aging. In his old age, he constantly babbled nonsense, so he was locked in a room for eternity.
Sisyphus was the king of Corinth. He sees a beautiful eagle with a maiden on its back on its way to an island. It turns out that the maiden was his daughter, Aegina. Sisyphus gets mad at Zeus, thinking that it was him who carried her off, but he was punished by Zeus for accusing him, so Zeus makes him push a rock up a hill in Hades for the rest of eternity.
The flute was invented by Athena, but she threw it away because in order to play it, she had to puff out her cheeks and disfigure her face. Marsyas, a satyr, found it and played it so enchantingly upon it that he declared to challenge Apollo to a contest. The god won, of course, and punished Marsyas by flaying him. The Amazons were a warring tribe of women. Most people call them men-haters, but they were a peaceful tribe towards one another, and they lived out their lives in the forest. The king of Arcadia was a very wicked man, so Zeus changed him into a wolf. One day, whenever Zeus went to someone's house, he saw human flesh on the table. Hera came along and changed the king of Arcadia's daughter into a bear. But Zeus loved her, and he put her up among the stars. Athena took an infant who was half man, half serpent, to a box. Although she warned the three daughters of Seros that they should never open the box. It was forbidden. But one of the daughters comes along and opens it whenever the infant has grown. Since Athena told them not to open it, she came out and drove the woman mad. Erechtheion then became the king. Orion was a wonderful player of the lyre. He went on a voyage. The men there hated him, so Apollo warned him. He plays a lyre to lure dolphins, and then the men came. They chase him, and he jumps over the boat, and the dolphins take